Good morning, students. We are going to start with our literature lesson number 8, Saving the Tiger. Children, Saving the Tiger, this lesson is a very interesting one. This talks about that how we can save tigers. This is not only by the effort of the government this can be possible, or by certain group of people or some reserves, only it is their duty to do so. But what we are going to learn in the lesson, that it is everybody's duty to give support in this, you can say, in this program. Okay, and this Saving the Tiger is written by Shekhar Dattari, and we are going to learn about this fellow, that he is an award-winning wildlife filmmaker. He has made many films on the animals and all, and he is a very good wildlife filmmaker. And you know, children, when he was just 13 years, he had started his lifelong fascination with the wildlife. And just we cannot even think of a child of 13 years of age can even think of going to the wildlife and doing all these sort of things. He has started as a volunteer in the beginning, then he learned many things from the seniors, and then he started doing all these things. He has written 3 children's books and a number of articles on conservation. Conservation means how we can conserve, how we can save, what all efforts we can make to really save animals. He has talked about many things in the articles, wildlife and filmmaking. Okay, this is all about Shekhar, and we are going to see in this lesson, this is one of his encounters, one of his own experience, which we will be reading in the lesson. I was 19 when I saw my first tiger in the wild. He had started working since 13 years, but when he was 19, he had his first encounter, means he saw the first time in his life, he saw the tiger in the wild, in the jungle. And it was every bit as thrilling as I had imagined. He says every moment, every aspect, everything there, when I saw that tiger there in the wild, I was thrilled, excited, super excited. He would have thought in the mind that when I will get a chance to see this animal, that animal, he would have got this idea, thought also in the mind, that someday definitely I will see the tiger. And this was the moment of his life when he actually saw the tiger in the wild. I was in Kanha Tiger Reserve in Madhya Pradesh. That time he was in Kanha Tiger Reserve, which is in Madhya Pradesh, seated on a young tame elephant that was barely 6 feet tall. Now, how we cannot go like that walking in the jungles and all, or in the reserves. We have different kind of vehicles there, some sort of jeeps there, or even on the elephants we can go inside the these reserves. Children, and this man says that he was sitting on a young tame elephant, young elephant, not at all a huge one which we can see, but it was a young elephant and it was just 6 feet tall. The elephant, or the elephant and its teenage mahout, were being trained to track tigers by more experienced trackers on much bigger elephants. It says mahout, we all know what they are, a person who works with, drives and looks after elephant, that is known as mahout. Now, on the 6 feet elephant, a very small child, teenage mahout, means barely, you can say hardly, you can say 13, 14, 15 or 16 or 17. Teenager, these years we call teenage, okay. And here it says that a young boy was sitting on it and were being trained, and that fellow was also being trained in this field of thing, and to track, and what he was getting the training from the senior ones, how to track the tigers. What is the meaning of tracking the tigers? To means to find tigers by following signs and such as their footprints. Whenever we have to track or find out where an animal could be, how we find by their footprints or by and different things. We have no experience of doing it, so we don't know much about it. But when you will ask the people in the reserves, they will tell you how and the ways how they can find out or track the places or the spots where you can get these animals to see. And this small teenage boy was also learning all these things, who was Mahot. And it says that on much bigger elephant, and all the experienced people, they were on the much bigger elephant, but these two fellows, that teenager Mahot and Shekhar, who was just 19 that time, he was sitting on that 6 feet elephant. Okay, after this what happened? I sat behind the boy Mahot. Mahot was sitting in front and he was sitting at the back of him and hang on to a rope for dear life. Now he was holding very tightly what? The rope which was tied there around the elephant. He was holding that rope so tightly, and for dear life means the rider held on to the rope as best as he could to avoid falling off. Whenever we are afraid or we think that we are going to fall off, whatever things we could manage to grab or hold, we definitely hold that thing very tightly so that we avoid falling. And it says he was holding the rope very tightly, and the elephant struggled up a steep slope amidst thick bamboo. In the wildlife sanctuary, when you will go, you will find that we don't have any pakka roads there, any metal road there. You will have all sorts of roads which are very uneven. So here elephant is climbing a slopey road, and amidst thick bamboo, and everywhere there was bamboo trees, and amidst means in the middle of that they had that slopey area. And suddenly a flash of orange caught my eyes, and something, he said, some orange color thing I saw, something which caught my eyes. I saw something suddenly while I was sitting on that elephant. For a heart stopping moment, our eyes met in mutual surprise. Our eyes means one is the writer, or you can say Shekhar, and another was the tiger. Both of them saw each other, and it was so close. It was, he says, it was heart stopping moment. Whenever we are thrilled or when we are trying to see something, and as soon as we see that thing, automatically we feel that we are totally gone somewhere. And it says the tiger was so close that he could have easily leapt onto our elephant and pulled us down. Means the tiger was so near to the elephant, and we know the height of the elephant was barely, it was 6 feet, and barely it was 6 feet. And it says that easily if that animal would have thought of jumping and coming on to us and killing us, that animal, that tiger, would have done that very easily. But it just sat there calmly, but it did not move from the place. The tiger sat on the same place, he was on the same place only, without moving, without jumping, without going away from there. He was calmly and quietly sitting in that place, looking at us with curiosity. Even the animal was very curious to look at these people. He also would be thinking, we exactly don't know what was going on in the mind of the animal, in the mind of the tiger, but he would be thinking something. Animal also can think many things, isn't it? So he would be thinking something. That is why it is mentioned with very with curiosity he was looking at these people. Then as my elephant gave a heave, now what is the meaning of lifted itself with great effort? It means started to move and climbed up to the top of the slope. When we are about to reach the top of the slope, means when we have a steep area and when we have to reach on top of it, then definitely we have to put little more effort to reach on top. And it says, as my elephant gave a heave, means lifted its legs or made little more effort to climb the top of it, top of the slope. What happened? The orange cat disappeared from view. The orange cat. This Shekhar is explaining or trying to explain you, orange cat doesn't mean that we are talking about cat, but we are talking about tiger here, which is almost orangish in color and disappeared. When he tried to look one more time that where it had gone, but he couldn't see because it was gone from there. Since that day, several decades ago, I have had many close encounters with wild tigers during my career as a wildlife filmmaker. But that glimpse, first glimpse, will always remain special. It says, after that also I had seen many tigers, but the first glance or first encounter or first view of the tiger is always special for me. Is very, very special in my heart, because always I wanted to see a tiger, and when I saw very first time in my life, that moment is, that moment I have captured in my heart, I have stored in my heart, and which is very fascinating for me. That moment I cannot forget in my life. And from the second paragraph, we are going to begin in the next video. I'm sure whatever I have taught you in the beginning of the lesson is quite clear to you. Please learn few, very few word meanings are there on page number 76. Please try to learn them. Thank you and take care.